Francis Drake, one of the greatest explorers of all time, second man to ever circumnavigate the globe. Was this all fun and games, or was the Queen's hope going to be shattered? Find out tonight on Behind the Journey.
Francis Drake was born near Tavistock, England in 1540. His first ship, the Judith, was used on a slave trading voyage in the Gulf of Mexico. 1577, Queen Elizabeth I secretly commissioned Drake to undertake an expedition on the Pacific coast of the New World, and he departed on December 13th from Plymouth, England. But was the Queen up to something? Yes, she was. It was actually an expedition against the Spanish colonies.
Well, it's not like I've never raided the Spanish before.
And he wasn't lying. In 1572, Drake commanded two vessels in a marauding expedition against Spanish ports in the Caribbean Sea. When he returned to England with a cargo of Spanish silver, Drake was taken to a Spanish court and was found guilty of several piracy charges, one of which was the capturing of Nombre de Dios. He also destroyed the nearby town of Portobello for no apparent reason.
All right, I'm going to straighten this out right now. It was an accident. I had a match, tossed it behind my back, I landed in some hay, and, I did it on purpose. Yeah, I said it.
But little did Drake know that this karma would haunt him forever. After crossing the Atlantic Ocean, Drake abandoned two of his ships in the Rio de la Plata estuary, only digging himself deeper in the hole of bad karma.
I wasn't gonna let those guys drag us down. That's why I left them there. Alone.
And alone they were. In 1578, the three remaining ships entered the Pacific Ocean. But a series of karma-caused storms that lasted for more than 50 days destroyed one ship. The other went home to England. Drake pressed on. In 1579, Drake reached the Moluccas Islands. He stopped at Calabas and Java, rounded the Cape of Good Hope on the south tip of Africa, and returned to England in September of 1580. In 1595, Drake's karma finally caught up with him, and he died at sea. We'll always remember you, Sir Francis Drake.
Don't let your love